Hello students, welcome back to Dr. Noor Fizojahan channel, wherein you are exploring the world of business management with Dr. Noor. Today we are here to discuss about the part 2 of communication. So part 1 I taught you about what is communication and process of communication. Today I am teaching you methods or types of communication. How many types of communication are there which you can use? So before we start with this topic, let me request you to subscribe to my channel. You have to do three things here, students. First, please subscribe to my channel. Watch complete videos. Correct? Watch complete video. Then share my videos, like my videos, and please go through all previous topics and well versed yourself with management skills. Yes. With that note, let me start with the methods or type of communication. So the type of communication can be broadly classified into three categories on the basis of structure, expressions, and direction. So communication can be broadly classified in three categories on the basis of structure, so expression, and direction. The structure, as you know, students, organization structure are of two types, formal and informal. So communication is also of two types. If you are communicating with a formal structure, we call it as formal communication. If you are communicating in an informal structure, we call it as informal communication. So type of communication, the first classification is on the basis of structure, that is formal and informal. Then expressions, how am I telling? See, I am talking to you through YouTube, orally I am talking to you. That is called oral expressions. Are written. Or in slide share, I can just share my slide to you. That is called as written communication. A manager can send circular, written communication. Our manager can go to the employees and talk about the matter what he want to explain. That is called as oral. The next communication can be broadly classified on the basis of direction also. So it can be the upward communication. Correct? That is from bottom to up. That is upward, downward, top to bottom, horizontal in the same line, or it can be diagonal. So these are, so totally types of communication can be broadly classified under three categories: structure, expression, direction. Structure 2, expression 2, direction 4. So totally 8 types of communication. One by one I am teaching you now. First, let me start with structure communication can be. So the communication, first part of first type of communication on the basis of structure, that is formal and informal. So can you see the diagram here? Formal, the very formally they are meeting. Informal, see, for example, you're talking to your teacher, maybe a very formal, or you're talking to your lecturer, correct? Very formal communication. On the other hand, you're talking to your boss, formal communication. But if you're talking to your friends, very informal communication. Look at the way they are greeting each other, correct? And look at the way they are greeting each other. Their dress code, to their body language, everything speaks about, is it a formal communication or is it an informal communication? So not only the word, students, which talks about, which makes your communication effective, but your dress code, your body language, your appearance also talks a lot. That is why communication, all those things you have to take care here. So what is formal communication? So formal communication is that which takes place between the line of authority, correct? Formal communication is that which takes place within the line of authority. Between the teacher and student, or between a boss and a subordinate, superior and subordinate, a manager and an employee, headmasters and teacher, correct? That is called as formal communication, which takes place within authority. Since I am your teacher, I have right to talk to you. So I am talking as a teacher, as a student, I am talking to you. Or a boss is talking to the employees, correct? And a supervisor is talking to the a supervisor is talking to the subordinate. So they observe the norms and conditions necessary to the hierarchy. So you have to observe the norms, rules, regulations and conditions to have such kind of interaction. In whichever direction this communication flows, it moves are always planned. Let it be upward or let it be downward. Maybe a student talking to teacher, maybe a teacher talking to student, we take care of certain norms. The student ensure that yeah, my teacher should not feel bad about it. So I'm going to talk in a very polite manner, proper wordings I'm going to use. In the same way, teacher also will think that my students should understand it properly and I should be able to communicate with them properly. So how am I going to talk? Both of them are going to talk in a similar dialogue. So let it be any upward or downward, the communication is well planned, dictated and guided. So maybe the formal meetings, all meetings are well organized, correct? Before meeting is there, we send the communication about meeting, then proper place is being decided where meeting will happen, then meeting will be recorded, and each and every person will speak in the meeting gets recorded. So one will think twice what to talk, what not to talk, because everything is going under recorded. That kind of communication, we call it as formal communication. It can be formal meeting or formal letter. Then what is the informal communication? Informal communication occurs when people come together and talk about their working conditions. See, there's no meeting. There's no superior and boss meeting here. All of them have gone to canteen and they start talking about their boss very badly or talking about the organization. Maybe good or bad. It can be anything. With so much of freedom they talk, they are not bothered because nothing is getting recorded here. There is no one to observe their behavior. They have bindas time and they talk about their working condition, about their boss, about their family, about their co-workers. Everything beautifully they talk. That is called as informal communication. Something they are so annoyed, they just go and ventilate on their friends. Very bad happened to me, this is what has happened, because nothing is recorded here, no one to observe, so freely they will speak. That kind of communication is called as informal communication. So it can be conveyed by gesture, so body language or nod or maybe a smile, correct? So talking with friends, gossips, rumors are the example of informal communication. So gossip can go to any extent, rumor can go to any extent, correct? And if friends, you don't have any formal talk with a friend, you can speak anything with your friend. That's the beauty of informal communication. But in an organization, though you can ask me, ma'am, do you think in organization informal communication is there? Yes, it will be there. Meeting, formal communication will over, directly they all will behave. Then as soon as they go outside, all of them will meet and start discussing about what happened in the boardroom. Freely they will talk. That is called as informal communication. Okay, so that is the first type of communication on the basis of structure. Then second, so the difference between the formal and informal communication. Formal communication is slow because it has a prescribed path. Informal communication has no path. So very quick it will follow. We say, you know, like how fire will spread in forest. Like that informal communication will flow out very fast. But formal communication will take time because it has to, meeting has to be arranged, meeting only you have to talk. So some 1 week before meeting, notice has to be sent. It is slow. It serves the organization need. Just to meet the organization need, formal communication happen. But informal is for social and as well as organization need. Position of parties are important here. A status or position is irrelevant here. See, status or position is very important in formal communication. HR manager talking to employee, CEO talking to employee, teacher talking to the students. But status position is not relevant when in informal communication. So contains the shorter vision of words or slang word, but here pronounced word, no slangs are allowed in formal communication and proper wordings you have to use that. Formal is very rigid. What is written, same thing you have to talk. Other than that, you can't talk anything. Informal is very much flexible. You can speak from your heart, whatever you are comfortable. So this is what we have under formal and informal communication. So then according to the expression, communication can be divided into oral and written. Like what I am talking to you is oral. If I write and send it to you, that is called as written. So on the basis of oral communication, it's quick, simple, comparatively more effective. It involves exchange of message with the help of spoken words. Oral communication may take place by face-to-face contact or through mechanical devices. Like I'm talking to you, it's a face-to-face. You are not meeting me directly, but I'm communicating with you through YouTube. I'm recording the video and sending it to you. But it's an oral communication. Correct? I'm not writing and sending it to you. So that's called oral communication, maybe face to face or through mechanical devices. If you are attending my class directly face to face, I can teach. Since you are not there with me, then what I am doing through mechanical device, YouTube, I am recording and sending. Then if you have, so oral communication, you can have interviews. Correct, oral communication can be seen in interviews or it can be negotiation. See, orally HR manager will come and start negotiating with the employees. 10% hike, is it fine? Or you want more? Please let me know. Let us clarify now itself. Then people will start talking. Then interviews. Interview is always oral. Where interviewer will ask some questions and interviewee will try to answer that. So then you have written communication, as the picture says. If rather than I am taking class like this, if I write everything and post it, then it is called as written communication. My blog, correct, where I am posting the information on communication, we call it as written communication. So where you have to read to understand, you can listen. See, oral communication, you have to listen. Written communication, you have to read. Most of the youngsters are preferring videos because you want to listen. You don't want to read, correct? So written communication is transmitted by what? In form of letters, memos, circulars, bulletins, report, instruction card, manual, magazines, handbook, etc. Written communication generally moves downwards. From, for example, top level management will send a circular to the employees, or notice to the employees, or summons to the employees, or report will be sent to the employees. That is called as written communication. It's a record of spoken words. So the difference between the written and oral communication is, oral feedback is easily, when I'm talking, I'll get to know what it is. So it's easy, but written feedback is delayed because people may not respond to me immediately. Oral is flexible, written is rigid. Oral, correct, will not have the permanent record, but it is authentic and credible records. So expensive and stable, written is expensive and stable. And spoken is economical. It holds good. See, oral message holds good for short messages. But when you have full rules of the company you have to inform, don't go for oral. No one will understand. Don't go for oral. No one will understand so much. Send a written document, they will go through it. So lengthy messages, written communication. Short messages, oral communication. Letter, memos, reports is written. Whereas the face-to-face meeting is what is oral. So that is what the difference between oral and written communication. Yes, students, able to follow that? Yes, we are doing the types of communication. We have done with, correct? We have done with two types of communication. That is, correct? We have done with the communication on the basis of oral and written. Expression on the basis of expression, oral and written. And the next, the previous type of communication I taught you about on the basis of structure, that is formal and informal. Yes, students, we are left with the third type of communication. So that I'll be doing it in my next video, because too much if I teach in one video, you will not understand. So whatever is being done, hope you understood that. Any doubt, please write down in the comment box. I'll be eagerly waiting to read your comments and reply you back. So till then, please keep watching my videos, sharing my videos, and subscribe to my channel. And see you in the next class. Till then, take care.